Good day, and welcome to Hiroshima University's English Podcast. Hi, everyone. I'm Joe.
And I'm Pearline.
Pearline, welcome to our podcast as a host. Pearline has helped us with these podcasts a bit in the past, but she'll be a host today.And will help us a lot with these podcasts later this year. Pearline, could you tell us a bit about yourself?
Yes, I'm a third-year student at Hiroshima University, majoring in global studies. I'm bicultural, American and Japanese, and I grew up mostly in Japan.
So you major in global studies? What kind of work do you want to do in the future?
Well,I'd love to work in the United Nations, doing something related to my current studies involving peace building.
Wow, promoting peace in the United Nations sounds great. Everyone, Pearline will tell us more about herself in the near future. I'm sure you'll all love her.
よろしくお願いします。
Pearline, according to our podcast title today,It seems like we're talking about sake. I love drinking sake.
No, no, Joe. We're not talking about drinking the alcohol drink sake. でも確かにたくさん日本についてあまり知らない外国人は日本酒の発音は sake をします。
Yes, I was only kidding there. For example, I think my parents pronounce the drink sake.
Yes.But today we're talking about a British writer named Saki, who lived about 100 years ago.
Yes, actually Saki was a pen name. His real name was Hector Hugh Munro, but most people know him as Saki.
Why was his pen name Saki?
Well, it has nothing to do with Nihonshu. There are two theories about why he called himself Saki.One idea says the name came from Persian literature.
So he was interested in Iranian poems?
Yes. And the other idea says that he took up the name of a unique South American monkey called a Saki, which he was also interested in.
So the origin of the name is not so clear, but those are two interesting ideas.Joe, can you tell us a little about Saki the writer?
Sure. He was born in 1870.
That's the beginning of the Meiji period.
And he was born in British Burma.
That's Myanmar today, between India and Thailand.
His father was one of the leaders of the British police force in Burma. And his mother died when Saki was only 2 years old.She was charged by a cow, had a miscarriage, and never recovered.
Ah, 牛に襲われて流産し回復できなかったんですね。Very sad. A lot of people died at a young age in those days.
Yes. After that, his father sent Saki back to southwestern England, and he was raised mostly by his grandmother and two aunts.
Oh, nice!Relatives helped raise him.
Yes, and his father sometimes took him to Europe and Burma.
Oh, he spent some time seeing the world.
Yes, and he went to Bedford School, which is one of England's oldest and best schools for teenagers.
Oh, he had a good education. He must have been smart.
He was. After graduating, he became a journalist in London.He worked for newspapers and magazines.
Sounds like fun.
And Saki especially liked writing short stories. Saki was influenced by three famous British writers. Lewis Carroll.
Oh, Lewis Carroll, the writer of Fushigi no Kuni no Arisu, Alice in Wonderland.
He was also influenced by Rudyard Kipling.
Rudyard Kipling.The British writer who grew up in India and wrote The Jungle Book. I liked that Disney movie.
And Saki was also influenced by Oscar Wilde.
Oscar Wilde was an Irish poet who was famous for his plays, Geki, in London in the 19th century. And Oscar Wilde was also famous for his humor.
So, the fantasies of Lewis Carroll, the adventures of Rudyard Kipling, and the humor of Oscar Wilde helped to make Saki a good writer.
That's correct. So, Joe, today in our podcast, we have one of Saki's most famous stories called...
The Open Window.
Joe, why is this story good?
It's good because it is scary.
Oh, everybody likes scary stories.
And the story is also good because all of the expressions in it are modern English, daily conversation words still used today. They are rather difficult expressions, but they are also beautiful expressions. And all native speakers today understand these words.
Oh, so useful, daily, beautiful conversation expressions.
Right. In this podcast, everyone, we do not have time to explain all of the words, but we will have a vocabulary list, so you can look at that list for easy explanations about the vocabulary expressions.
このポッドキャストでは全ての単語を訳す時間はないので、単語リストを記載しております。なので簡単な説明のためにそちらの単語リストをご覧ください。So Joe, can you tell us about the general outline of the story in easy words?
Sure, Pearline. It's a story about a nervous man who moves to a town and he doesn't know anyone there.
Oh, 緊張気味な人。
Right. So he goes to a big house to try to meet the people, and the girl there tells him about a tragedy which happened at the house 3 years before.
Oh, higeki. What kind of tragedy?
It involves the girl's aunt, who still lives in the big house. One day, the aunt's husband and her two young brothers went out hunting.
Okay, the three men of the house went out hunting.
They left the house like they always did, through a large French window.
彼らはいつも通り大きな窓から家を出ました。
But while hunting, they were engulfed by a treacherous bog.
しかし、狩りをしている途中、すごく大きな沼に飲み込まれてしまいました。
Yes, they drowned in a swamp, and their bodies were never recovered.
Oh, that means nobody ever found them.
That's right. Ever since that time, the aunt had left the French window open so that they could return.
Oh, sounds nice. But a little strange. 3 years have already passed. They are clearly dead. Why would she leave the window open even during the cold winter?
Yes, maybe the aunt is crazy? Anyway, remember, it's nighttime. The strange aunt comes into the room. Then, while the nervous man is talking to the aunt and the girl, three men outside in the dark quietly walk across the lawn toward the French window.
そのおばさんが部屋で緊張気味の男と女の子と話している間、男3人が静かに大きな窓に向かって歩いていたのです。
Yes, three men are walking noiselessly toward their open window, and they all have guns.
Ah, sounds scary. What will happen?
Let's find out as we listen to Hiroshima University's English podcast version of Saki's...
The Open Window.
The Open Window. My aunt will be down presently, Mr. Nato, said the self-possessed young lady of 15. In the meantime, you must put up with me.Frampton Nuttall tried to make pleasant conversation while waiting for the aunt. Privately, he He doubted more than ever whether these formal visits on total strangers would help the nerve cure which he was supposed to be undergoing in this rural retreat. I'll just give you letters to all the people I know there, his sister had said. Otherwise, you bury yourself and not speak to a soul, and your nerves will be worse than ever from mobbing. Do you know many people around here? Asked the niece.
Hardly a soul. My sister gave me letters of introduction to some people here.
Then you know practically nothing about my aunt? Continued the self-possessed young lady.
Only her name and address, admitted the caller.
Her great tragedy happened just 3 years ago, said the child.
Her tragedy?
Asked Flamton. Somehow, in this restful spot, tragedies seemed out of place. You may wonder why we keep the window open so late in the year, said the niece, indicating a large French window that opened on a lawn. Out through that window, 3 years ago to a day, her husband and her two young brothers went off for their day's shooting. In crossing the moor, they were engulfed in a treacherous bog. Their bodies were never recovered. Here, the child's voice faltered. Poor aunt always thinks that they'll come back someday. They and the little brown spaniel that was lost with them and walk in the window. That is why it is kept open every evening till dusk. She has often told me how they went out. Her husband with his white waterproof coat over his arm. You know, sometimes on still evenings like this, I get a creepy feeling that they will all walk in through that window. She broke off with a little shudder. It was a relief to Frampton when the aunt bustled into the room with a wail of apologies for keeping him waiting.
I hope you don't mind the open window, she said. My husband and brothers will be home directly from shooting, and they always come in this way.
She rattled on cheerfully about the prospects for duck shooting in the winter. Frampton made a desperate effort to turn the talk to a less ghastly topic, conscious that his hostess was giving him only a fragment of her attention, and that her eyes were constantly straying past him to the open window. It was certainly an unfortunate coincidence that he should have paid his visit on this tragic anniversary. The doctors ordered me a complete rest from mental excitement and physical exercise, announced Frampton, who imagined that everyone, even a complete stranger, was interested in his illness.
Oh? Said Mrs. Supperton, vaguely. Then she suddenly brightened into attention, but not to what Frampton was saying.
Here they are at last, she cried. In time for tea and muddy up to the eyes.
Frampton shivered slightly and turned towards the niece with a look intended to convey sympathetic understanding. The child was staring through the open window with dazed horror in her eyes. Frampton swung round and looked in the same direction. In the deepening twilight, three figures were walking noiselessly across the lawn, a tired brown spaniel close at their heels. They all carried guns, and one had a white coat over his shoulders.
Frampton grabbed his stick. The hall door and the gravel drive were dimly noted stages in his headlong retreat. Here we are, my dear, said the bearer of the white Macintosh. Who was that who bolted out as we came up?
An extraordinary man, Mr. Nato, said Mrs. Supporton. He could only talk about his illness and dashed off without a word of apology when you arrived. One would think he had seen a ghost.
I expect it was the spaniel, said the niece calmly. He told me he had a horror of dogs. He was once hunted into a cemetery on the banks of the Ganges by a pack of stray dogs, and had to spend the night in a newly dug grave, with the creatures snarling and foaming above him. Enough to make anyone lose his nerve.
So, the nervous man dashed off, ran away in a headlong retreat.
要するに、緊張した男はすごいスピードで走り出したのですね。I would have dashed off in a headlong retreat too.
But the family members thought it was strange that he ran away. They all thought he was afraid of the dog.
Wasn't it strange that the three men had been away for 3 years?Maybe they were all ghosts.
Everyone, we hope you liked our story today, written by Saki.
Yes, there are a lot of difficult words in it, but as we explained, they are all daily conversation words. If you look at the vocabulary list, you will understand them.
Yes, next month we'll be back with one more famous story by Saki.
Oh, I can't wait.
Everyone,See you next time at Hiroshima University's English Podcast. Bye.
Bye.